Carlsbad Porn Structure Part 6. Today we'll have an overview over Black's options against the dreaded minority attack. As you probably know, this structure here is the Carlsbad structure. And as we have mentioned many times, it can occur in the Queen's Gambit, Declined, in the Caro-Kann Exchange, Rogozin, Semislav, anything like that. So it's a very important pawn structure, and it's good to know what to do. You will get to play, if you play normal openings, you will reach this kind of position at some point. We will use this board as an example of White's plan and Black's different option. Here, White's plan is basically to go forward the pawn and make this pawn weak. This is the minority attack. And then Black will have weak pawns. And Black can respond to this idea in a lot of ways. Usually there will be a lot of pieces on the board. In general, the more pieces, the better for Black in some way. It's not always clear. And nothing is set in stone in this Carlsbad structure. Anyway, we're gonna switch the scene now to the 8 different plans. You can get this in the notes, but you can also just write it down. And here we go. And we were called Boomer for having a white background, so now it's Black. Just for a little while, we will probably get another background anyway. Black options versus the minority attack, and he actually has, or she, have 8. Options. 8. That's a lot. Okay. So the first one is leave the queen side as it is. That is, just let White play the pawn forward and saddle Black with a weak pawn. In meanwhile, Black will try to attack on the king side. You could also do this, but with having the a pawns exchanged, then you will have one weakness less on the queen side and might be able to use some of the open files over there, but you will also give White an extra open file on the queen side. You can prepare to meet b5 with c5. We're gonna see this in all these different plans. I'm gonna show it, so don't worry if it sounds very abstract. It is kind of simple, but it will take some time to. And the thing is, the plans always intermix. Sometimes you should use one, sometimes you should use the other, and it all depends, like we have talked about before, like all complex things like in chess. It will depend on the exact position. And you can also do the same, playing meeting b5 with c5 with the a pawns exchange. And then you can play a6, and when White goes b5, you go a5, and then you will get the b4 square, usually to a bishop. We'll also look at this. You can also play a6 and take on b5 and play a5, and you will have a free a pawn, and but you will have a weak d pawn. We'll also look at this. Then you can put you can just stop White from doing anything and play b5, and you will get a weak pawn on c6, and e4 might be coming. But if you can put a knight on c4, usually this is not so bad. And then you can play in Tatakova style, which I would call it, and play b6, and when b5 come, you play c5, and you're ready to take back with the b pawn. Okay, these were the options, and of course we will later see some games where it is explained why when to choose what, so you will have a clear idea when you are playing. This is what we're aiming for here. It will take some time. It's not so simple, but you will be smarter about the Carlsbad structure after seeing this video and the 5 prior to this one and the one to come. Anyway, let's go to the board. We will switch scene again. Okay, so White go b4, and Black just ignores it. Here we'll just move the king just to explain it, and we'll have this structure here. And of course, there will be a lot of pieces on. This is just to simplify it. We see that white black has a weak pawn here. And if it's exchanged versus the d pawn, then this or lost, this pawn will be weak. So in general, black structure is compromised. You don't want an isolated pawn like the pawn on c6. But if you can defend it, then you might be able to start an attack over on the king side, just to show where you might strike with your pieces if you can. If white uses all his forces to go after the pawn on c6. So usually white will have to take some prophylactic measures to stop white black from getting a counterplay. It will lead to a full flush battle. Okay, other options: b4, king f8, a4, a6, and here we just pretend b5 doesn't lose a pawn. Oops, it's white. And here we will have the same, king of e8, and we'll have the same, but with the a pawn exchanged. This was option number two, and here we see that the difference here is there are two open files here, and sometimes black will be able to occupy the a file and generate activity in that way, sort of combining attack and defense on the A-file. Okay, option, and it's like a lecture on the university, this here. And here we just move, and we will just to show, so it doesn't lose a pawn immediately, it will look ridiculous, and B5 and C5. This was options three, meeting B5 with C5. Usually this is not a real option because white will try to prevent it. Like the game we saw with Van Wiele, he didn't allow c5, and we also seen some Karpov stuff where he didn't allow c5, because it, in general, it's even though what will result here is that the b pawn is no longer exercising much pressure, and black will get a weak d pawn. But, and this is the problem, this might not be so easy to attack as the c6, and it's not as weak, it will be easier to defend it. And this is the problem in isolated queen pawn positions. Usually white's pawn would be back here, and among other things, making the c file stronger. So in this situation, the problem is that white black often get counterplay in the c file, and can use the c5 square, which is also annoying. So this plan is, in general, if black can do this, he's usually okay. It's not worse, because this d pawn is not so weak when white's queen side is weakened. Okay, next plan, number four. b4, a6, a4, king f8, and we'll just to not lose a pawn, and here maybe this, we'll play something like this, and here, and just to show it, this is the same structure just with the a pawn exchange. I think this is probably a little better for white, because sometimes he can use the a file to try and attack this pawn down here on b7. And again, there is the counterplay on the c-file, and there is a weak square, and we should probably make that red here. But this can also be weak, and sometimes it goes lost. So this is option number four. Then there is option number five, and I hope I remember correctly which one it was. It was after b4, a6, a4, king f8, b5, take, and this time he took with the c pawn, and a5. And usually this is played with a knight coming here. The good news is that this pawn might be weak, but the bad news is often black will get problems in the c file. This pawn is weak, and if it's lost, white will have a very strong center. And even though this pawn is a free pawn, it's seldom that it gets to really rock and roll and go far. So this, I think this is possible, this plan, but it's not the best plan. And maybe this was not plan number five, maybe this was plan number six, because I just realized there is another plan here. And this is, and after b5, just to go a5. So it's like plan number one, but with the pawn on a5 instead of a6. The idea here is that this square might be useful for a black squared bishop. So if you have a black squared bishop you can put here, then you might be able to control the queen side. There was a famous game where Spassky played this against Korchnoi, and Korchnoi was very annoyed, and it was a quick draw. So this is another option. I'm a little bit skeptic about this. It seems fine and it's very elegant just to go forward with a5 and get in the b4 square. But in general, when white managed to maneuver successfully here, he will win one of the pawns and you will lose a horrible game. So I'm a little bit wary about this, and also the c takes b5, a takes b5, a5 solution. Okay, so we come to number 7, and that is simply on b4 to go b5. Maybe not in this position, maybe not, but here the idea is of course there will be no b5, and there will be a weak pawn on c6, yes. Sometimes black can play a5, but usually white will get the a4 in, so there will be something like a6, and there are some squares here that could be weak. There's also a plan for white to go e4, because this pawn now is quite weak, and in general it's much weaker than the d pawn. But black of course also has some ideas. At the moment his pawn structure is very solid, and he would love to put a knight, and we'll make it yellow here. If you could put a knight on c4, it will be a great piece, and if black white takes it, black will have a strong passed pawn, and if it will be sheltering this weak pawn here, which we will make red like this. So and this if carried out successfully, it's not so easy. Usually white is kind of careful not to allow this. He's kind of careful not to allow that black gets to set this up and put a knight on c4 without being sort of blown away on the king side or something. So, but if black successfully sets this up, it's usually kind of a good setup. And then we come to the last one. After b4, black goes b6, and this is more a Tatakova style thing. And after something like b4, you'll play c5 and be ready to take back with the pawn. This is, of course, sort of elegant and can be good. It can be the problem for black is often that this pawn structure, white doesn't have to go b5. He can wait. He can go a4, a5, or he can go e4, or he can do something else with the pieces. And this pawn is pretty weak usually, so it has to be guarded, and guarding it will make black's pieces more clumsy. Anyway, this was the overview over the Carlsbad pawn structure playing black against the minority attack. And there are many options, and it's kind of, I know if it's kind of overwhelming that there were the 8 options, we'll just have a look at them again, just so you don't forget. It's easier when you see examples. So in the coming videos on the Carlsbad structure, we will have some examples on black using these options. But at least now you know they exist. This was DM Talks. Thank you for watching.